This is the Guermont British News, presenting the world to the world. Grand weather, record crowds, and a perfect entry course, all these made up a sparkling prelude to the Grand National of 1948. Passions, as always, had their own place in the sun, but only a fraction of the normal motor traffic had its place in the car park. Over now to the paddock for a glimpse of some of the large field of 43, including last year's winner, Corhu. And here's that fine veteran, Prince Regent. Now a look at the weighing-in room, where the final checkup's in full swing as the time of the big event draws near. Without delay, they're in the saddle, and before long comes the colourful parade of thoroughbreds, all set for the world's greatest test of horse and rider. Over at the start, the final tense moments drag by as they get into line. Another pause and they're off. A sweeping cavalry charge and a brave challenge to the 4.5 dangerous miles ahead. First to break the line is Loch Conn, with Sheila's Cottage, Gormanstown and Happy Home thundering ahead as they approach the first fence. First over is Loch Conn, closely followed by Gormanstown, Happy Home and Sheila's Cottage, and here are the first two casualties, Brissett and Serpentine. Jump number three, and somebody else comes to grief as Loch Conn continues to make the pace. Coming up now to that number one hazard, the mighty Beecher's Brook. Loch Conn goes over like a bird, but hopes are dashed for many backers as the favourite Silver Fame comes down. So does Sun Chicken. And they go to the canal turn, and it's Dunkerrig in the lead, Sir John, Happy Home, Loch Conn, Schubert, and Ulster Monarch following, and here's but another jockey parts company with his mount. Slow motion at Valentine's, and the order's still the same as the chasers take the brook in their stride. Jump 13, Dunkerrig's over. No, bad luck, he's down, and a whole crowd of other challengers move to the front. Here's the new leader, first of the dandies, going all out to take jump 15. Zahir follows, while the rear ranks are thinned out as the jump takes its toll. Over the water, and still the same small handful of leaders clearing the hazard in immaculate style. Round the bend and the start of the second circuit. First of the dandies, two lengths ahead, Zahir, Happy Home, Sheila's Cottage, Roland Roy, all full of going as they take jump 17. Here we part company with another runner whose jockey lands in the fence on the right. Two jumps ahead and we say goodbye to some more of the field with one fall and a bad collision. Jump 21, still in the lead, first of the dandies. First the challenge by Sheila's Cottage, now coming on with terrific spirit. But for Highland Laird, it's the end of the race. Beecher's again, and almost together, first of the dandies and Sheila's Cottage, while the brook claims another victim. Jump 23, and again that commanding leader, first of the dandies, pursued by Sheila's Cottage and Happy Home. They're all as steady as a rock, and so it seems with an equal chance of victory as they approach the canal turn. they battle on for the loose horse between the leaders and Sheila's Cottage, number 22, gaining ground at jump 27. Jump 28, and Sheila's Cottage, now in second place, keeps up the game of follow my leader, with Zaheer challenging close behind. Jump 29, and now First of Dandies feels the challenge of Sheila's Cottage close on his heels. Now came disaster for Zaheer, number 30, who ran out of the course following a loose runner. The last jump, with First of the Dandies and Sheila's Cottage in a breathtaking battle for the lead. There's Sheila's Cottage going onto the rails, putting every ounce into a struggle of nerve and stamina. Neck and neck to the last 100 yards. Somebody's going to crack, but it isn't Sheila's Cottage. Here she comes, streaking home to a spectacular win by a length, with First of the Dandies and Cromwell in second and third places. What a race, and what an achievement for the first mare in 46 years to be a national winner. Whatever the racegoers thought, and they thought plenty, there's no doubt about the magnificent performance of Sheila's Cottage and her jockey, Arthur Thompson. The call at the weighing-in room gives him a well-earned breather, while for the owner of Sheila's Cottage, Mr. J. Proctor, this was also a crowning moment, made more so by the trainer's wife, Mrs. L. Crump. The trainer himself has a special pat for his winning charge, a very proud lady of the turf who takes her place in the Grand National's roll of fame.